What's good, y'all? We taking another trip, man. Smack is back, back, back.
Boy.
When I was in jail, I was low-key. Shout out to supporters that wrote me. Eat food, work out, and then go sleep. You know I'm praying he carrying both feet. Know we got God with us. He look at me and see a God figure. And when I stop vibing, I know that after me, I can always catch a hard shiver. I know it's demons in that dark liquor. We buy a bottle and squash. Switch up, everybody turn into a harsh.
Flawless.
My heart richer, my mind smarter. My grind harder and my car quicker. I'm at her in church, she pray for me. She my God sister. Yeah, I'm only trusting the people I keep close. Keep close, and I was diamonds and houses and sea notes. I'm feeling marvelous, let the monster loose. They call me a product of my environment. I tell them no, I'm a God producer.
What's good? Episode 3, Phoenix Vlog, man. Me and my dog got up real early. 4 o'clock in the morning, 4:30. Shot promo 1. Got some nice B-roll for that. You know, just telling the story. What Network Work kind of represents and what it brings. We've been up all morning. It's 10:30 now in the morning. Eating a little breakfast. Shout out G. Hooked it up. Man, felt like I was getting a football practice. 4 o'clock in the morning, for real. I heard that alarm and wanted to snooze it. But we got it though. That's gonna look real good. So, can't wait for that. We just chilling right now. About to, you know, watch a little TV game for a little bit or whatever. Just be on the laptop working, you know, getting some stuff done. But after that, we gonna shoot more parts of promo 1 and get more of promo 2. It's gonna be nice, a lot of good storytelling. 4 o'clock in the morning. You know, got up and set up in time for the sunrise, so that's why we got up so early. So it played a part in what this promo will represent, getting your mind right, because, you know, your body might be tired, but your mind is never off order. It's all connected like that. And then later on, we're going to go see Mike Bell, man, for the Saints. I can't wait. Super Bowl champion 44, you know, Saints versus the Colts down in Miami, you know. That's when Drew Brees got his first rank, you know? Man, hell froze over that day. We did it. Tracy Porter came clutch with a pick 6. That game had me hyped, my whole family. So I can't wait to meet Mike Bell, man. He was a dog, hard runner. Always was. Number 2-1, man. So then after that, we gonna go to the arcade. But you know, before we have fun, get all the work done. Get that uploaded to my laptop, and you know, and then when it's time to edit all that, you know, it's time to go. But yeah, so that's a big word. That's Dave right there. We got Mo coming. Smack ain't done. KJ ain't done. You hear me? We got a lot coming, and y'all gonna enjoy this. I know y'all is. Smack Entertainment, never off work. We out here, dog. You hear me? So don't go nowhere. What's good? That boy Smack is back. Shoot, we about to go shoot the other part of promo 1 and 2. About to get them shots for that. You know, my dog getting me right. Got these now shirts. Now I got a white one, you heard me? So you already know, man. Merch on deck. I better cop that, so. We out of here.
Yeah.
All right, love. It's really raining out here. Yeah, we about to get these other shots, y'all.
1 hour later.
We just got done filming another scene. Everything looking official. You feel me? That coffee machine work over there, son? Mm-hmm. About to make me some Starbucks, man. Well, stop raining.
Here it is.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we sunny all day tomorrow. Oh, yeah, all day sunny tomorrow.
Let's get the gym shots. All right, we about to shoot him. Bucket, okay, just for the vlog. Show me something, son. Got it on there, though. I'll whoop me some ping pong.
You nice that ping pong?
Kind of nice, huh?
Oh, nice, too.
I heard other people say that, too. We at the gym now getting these shots, man.
I could go up there and hit the bag a little bit.
Yeah, we could do that, too. Don't look like Tyler Herro. Oh, my God.
What?
Sir, how he was hitting them bags, sir? I don't know what he was doing.
20 minutes later.
Just filmed another scene. We moving on to the next. This gonna come out amazing. I promise y'all. So we out here, man. You know, I had to put on the Ralph. No USA. They going at USPA. So we out here, man. Me and my dog.
Got the pet. Got the pet. You know what I'm saying? We out here. Legal trapping.
You hear me? Got the packs. We going to go see my dog, Saints legend, Super Bowl 44, you heard me? The one and only Mike Bell. My dog Kev hooked it up, so we about to go chill with him for a little minute, see what it do. I know he busy, so we might not be able to, you know, hang out too long, but we going to make it work, though. So we on our way. We finna get it going.
What I said seems to never extinguish. Coolest kid out, baby, word to Chuck English. Count my own money, see the paper cut fingers. My song is your girlfriend's waking up ringer. Or alarm or whatever. She be here at 6 in the morning if I let her. But I never get attracted to fans cause the eager beaver.
So we about to pull up at KJ's Mon Dukes. See my dog Mike Bell, man. So we taking a little break from the promo. We gonna hang out and chill with Mike and them. Get some good food in us. Gonna meet another part of KJ family, so this gonna be cool. See my dog Mike Bell.
Remains in the game and gets the call again. And down.
Oh my God.
And look at Mike Bell's stature, and it doesn't immediately scream power back. Inside runner. Look at him, just lower his shoulder and runs through the initial tackle by Channing Crowder.
So what you them last four playoff losses? What you think happened, man? Let me pick your brain on that. Let me know something, Big Mike.
They got cheated on one of them.
I told y'all.
They got cheated on one. They definitely got cheated.
I told y'all.
That's they got. One was a fluke.
I told y'all that too. One was a fluke. And then you got the fluke. You got the Rams when they got cheated.
That was blatantly cheating.
Blatantly. Why do they do the Saints like that? Even shocked. Like during 09, they want to call the bounty gate and all of that.
Oh yeah, oh my goodness.
What would you think? Because you on that team. Let me in on the bounty gate scenario.
I was on the opposite side of the ball, so I really didn't know much too much was going on. But okay. I know what we was doing. And know every other team was doing. Okay. They just needed somebody as a scapegoat. You know what I mean?
Scapegoat.
They were the fall guy, I should say. Everybody was doing what he was doing.
What make you think us being the fall guy? Why you think that played a part?
You said what?
Why do you think they pinpointed the Saints to be the fall guys? Like, why us?
We're on top. They had to get the guy on top. We're going to get the most media attention to give us a lesson.
And a small
market team. Nobody's invincible. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Because, I mean, I don't see why it's bad to put an incentive to hit somebody.
Yeah.
Not to hurt nobody, it's to hit them.
To hit them.
So people are just going extra hard because you not only get your paycheck, but you, I mean, there's nothing wrong with it,
man. I told y'all. You know what I'm saying?
It's all a fun game. Man. Every team does it. So they wanted to make a fall guy. They picked the best team and they did that.
That's crazy. And that hurt. That hurt the team. Lost Sean Payton for a year.
Exactly.
Lose Jonathan Bowman for a year. So now he's kind of rusty coming back. And then he eventually retired like a year and a half after that. Scott Fujita got benched, and he went to Cleveland.
He was with you in Cleveland.
You went there too after that year. Like the dynamics had just changed. Offense was still good, but the defense had fell apart. We was the 32 team out of the league for most yards every week. I wonder why Drew was throwing about 5,000 every year.
Exactly.
That hurt because he was really in his prime. He really was like, okay, I'm really one of the best now. Definitely. Like I really am one to ring. It's time to just take it to the top. But Roger Goodell, ain't that something?
I know, man. Roger Goodell is not that guy.
He's not that guy, man. He's not that guy.
I'm not a fan of dictator type owners or commissioners and all that. That's one thing I didn't like about professional sports is that aspect of it. It came off
almost like I couldn't have fun sometimes.
Fun or just Big Brother's always pointing the finger of what you can and can't do. And I'm like, we're the people out there sacrificing our lives daily.
Exactly.
On the field for everybody's entertainment. And we have no control. And that kind of, that aspect of the game made me not like it that much. So after my fifth year in, I kind of like, I don't want to do this anymore.
Don't want to do it no more. Wow.
Because you could have played a lot of more years after that, you think?
My goal was 8, and I'm a firm believer you can do whatever you put your mind to. So that was my goal, but I was burnt out after 6 years.
Burnt out?
Yeah, I broke my ankle too, so that's really what did. I broke my ankle, and I was like, it's not worth it for me to rehab back and come back and go through all this mental anguish. I have kids and a family. It's not worth it.
It's not worth it.
You know what I mean? Yeah. They were young. My kids were like...
And that's your daughter right there, correct?
Yep. Or 1 and 2. We're babies.
Babies, huh, bro?
Yeah, because I stopped in 2013. She's in 2011, my mother in 2012. So 1 and 2. Yeah, it's a fun game, man, but that era of my life is over with, you know what I mean?
It's over with. You behind you now, huh?
Behind me now, and I'm not coaching, I'm not training, I'm not doing none of that no more. I'm just enjoying my life now.
Enjoying this life. Y'all hear it, man. Yep. Mike Bell, he just enjoying life. Post-retirement, he did it, man.
Yep.
He did it. He did it the right way. Played hard for my city. This thing right here, they can't never take it from us. I don't care how much they bring it up, bound it. With him and Drew and them put together, can't true nobody
fans.
Take it.
I respect it, man.
True fan.
True fan.
True fan.
In New Orleans, just in general,
we're just true fans,
just
true dog.
Fans, and I just respect that so much. Like, it's so genuine and so passionate. Yeah. I'm just like
if you go back, they gonna love you still.
Exactly.
If you go back, man, Mike Bell show up on Bourbon right now.
100%.
Come on, man.
Even in Denver, they show me more. They don't show me no love here. And I'm like, I went to
see
high school.
Not Arizona. Arizona. Y'all better get right.
Exactly.
Y'all better get right. Treat my dog with some respect.
Some respect. That's
Mike Bell.
Arizona. I always rep Denver.
Oh, it gotta rep Denver, man. Y'all better stop playing with my dog. Smack is out. They call me Smack, Mike B. They call me Smack. I'm gonna have to smack some fuck.
Tell them.
You know what I'm saying? Y'all got my dog Mike Bell messed up. You heard me? Shoot. But man, this is dope, man. Appreciate you stopping over. I just want to give a shout out. I'm thankful for him stopping over. Like he said, you know, that life of being a football athlete is over with. So, you know, he didn't have to take out his time and you know, and want to spend time and talk to a fan. He didn't have to do that. So
it's I just want to say thank you. I always appreciate somebody that shows love. So like I said, we could get together. I can get you some signed football cards. I got other football cards.
Definitely. Oh, yeah. I need one of those. I need a couple.
I'll get you a football card. I'll get you a Super Bowl one. I'll get you a Super Bowl one.
Say that one more time for the camera.
I'll get him a Super Bowl one. Where does Vaughn? If I have one, let me know. If I have one.
Oh,
I have
man.
A collection of them. So whatever I have, I'll give.
Okay,
if I have a Super Bowl one, I'll give it to you.
That's real. That's real. Mike Bell, appreciate you, man. My dog.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate you.
Mike Bell, y'all. My dog.
I'm gonna take a picture and post it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, appreciate that.
Yes,
sir. You on Facebook, right?
Yeah. Hey, I'm going to add you, Mike.
Michael, you still driving?
You a legend, dog.
30 years of friendship.
Smack Entertainment.
Yes, sir! Mike Bell, y'all. Legend, man. Who that?
Son. Your life changed, bro.
Son, Mike Bell, son. My dog hooked it up, bro. Dog.
It's so funny,
yeah.
I told you.
It's nice meeting you. I'm getting a real good friend. It's nice meeting you.
I cheered Pop Warner, and that's how I met him.
Wow, so y'all go way back.
Yeah,
before he made it to the NFL.
Oh yeah, we've been friends since like fifth grade. I cheered.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
So him making it, was that like big news? Like, I mean, cause that's like such, I mean,
no,
I guess it don't really matter
because
you were so.
When Michael was younger, if you asked him like, what are you gonna do when you grow up? He would just be like, oh, I'm gonna play for the Broncos. So I'm gonna be in the NFL. Like he just always said it. So I went to NAU in Flagstaff. He went to U of A, which is like 4 hours away, and I would like drive down for the game. He would like come and see me run with his family. We were just always
ran
very,
track.
Very close.
So you was a sprinter?
Yeah,
I was a sprinter. 100 to 200?
Yeah, I hated the 200.
Curve?
I was just little.
Yeah, mommy,
so my strides were little.
Oh, okay. Okay, your mom's prepared some food for us. We opened up some fortune cookies, and it really is all connected type stuff. Crazy, right? All magic what me and KJ was doing this whole week. This entire week. When I tell y'all it's all connected, it really is all connected.
I love you so much.
I love you.
You have pretty hair.
Thank you. As y'all just saw, I just met Saints legend Mike Bell. Y'all heard me say that name probably 50 times in the last 2 minutes. They gonna sign some stuff for me. So he's showing buku love, y'all. I'm excited. This has been fun.
Thank you.
And We got more shooting to do. We got a whole lot of more shooting to do. So don't go nowhere. I got more content for y'all, man. You heard me? All right. Thank you for inviting me over.
Yeah, no problem.
This was really fun. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Love you too.
Bye-bye, baby girl.
Say bye-bye.
All right, y'all. My dog KJ hooked it up. You heard me? Met his moms, met his little baby sister. Y'all seen the official Super Bowl for the Saints, man? Official Super Bowl ring.
You wore the ring, bruh.
Really?
How you feel?
Like, I wore the ring, dog.
How you feel, bruh? Let me interview son, you on your own vlog, bro.
Son, I'm feeling good, son. Like, I feel like I'm one of them. I've been one of them,
you
but now.
You have a Saints Super Bowl championship ring on your finger, bruh.
Son, I'm one of them now, bro. I'm one of them. They ain't gonna believe it, bro. But it's all—they
gotta believe,
they gotta believe it. It's all on tape. I'm a real life New Orleans Saint for real. So that was fun, y'all. I got his number. Dude gave me his number. So we gonna pull up on Mike Bell again before I leave, probably Monday, and get some signed autograph cards from him. So we on our way to the arcade. We gonna go have some fun, some more fun. So. Y'all stay tuned, don't go nowhere. Cause we live, baby. We out here. Alright? Smack Entertainment. Never off work. You heard me? We out here, man. So me and my dog, we downtown with it. You heard me?
It's been a productive day.
Uh-huh.
We're about to have a little fun. I'm just having a good day, bro. I'm in a good mood. My energy is right. I'm real grateful. For this weekend so far.
Okay.
If we don't do nothing else this weekend, which we is still gonna do more, but if we don't do nothing else, it's already been a success.
It's already been
my
a success.
Boy out here,
oh, yeah.
I got to see him meet, you know, somebody he really admired.
Oh yeah.
I know how passionate he is about the Saints. I got to see my boy wear the Saints only Super Bowl championship ring. That just made me feel real good for him, bro. You
know what I'm saying? So, bruh, my night was made. Hyped. Oh, yeah, the Mortal Kombat 3? Oh, yeah, bruh. We're in the Mortal Kombat with it.
Having the time of my life.
Lit, dog.
Yeah, what's straight, bro?
Big dog. No little dog, man. We out here making moves, man. Had a good time. Promo work. Hung out with Mike Bell. Saw more KJ family. And I held a Super Bowl ring. Can y'all hear me? I hold the Saints only Super Bowl ring, man. The only Super Bowl ring. I held that. Put it on. Took pictures with it. Hung out with Mike Bell, the only Mike Bell, y'all. Cobra Arcade, play some of my favorite games growing up as a little boy, you know? I'll be back at the crib, man. It's been a long day. We gotta get back early in the morning, you feel me? So, we just chilling, man. Cooling, vibing, my dog. Showing buku love, man. So, from like the Vegas trip, man, the Houston trip, my people's out there. KG out here in Phoenix, his girl, dog, everything just been smooth, everything been perfect, man. So, God is good, dog. I'm having too much fun. Way too much fun. I hope y'all enjoying this, because I am. If y'all not, I'm enjoying this, dog, to the fullest. I'm enjoying this, dog, like, man. Y'all ain't enjoying it, man. Y'all better. So, gotta wrap it up right. Y'all stay tuned, keep watching. Don't go nowhere, Smack Entertainment, man. We out here. Never off work.
It's all good, I'm going off like lights when the show's over. Make pasta, rent a movie, call's over. Rest in peace to Heath Ledger, but I'm no joker. I'll slow roast ya, got no holster. Wet glass on your table, nigga, no coaster. Burn bread every day, boy, no toaster. G and Taz got a cig, but I'm no smoker. They just